Would you like to learn about the cloud architecture process? If so, this video is for you. In this video, we are going to discuss how to design a cloud architecture or an enterprise architecture. Many people confuse cloud architecture with cloud engineering. The reality is they're very different careers. Cloud engineering is all about building the tech, while cloud architecture is all about enabling digital transformation. Since the key to being an exceptional cloud architect or enterprise architect is to help your customer be successful with their digital transformation, it's essential to understand the digital transformation process. The following cloud architecture process is widely used by elite cloud architects and enterprise architects alike. You can think of digital transformation as the process of improving a customer's business performance with technology. In this video, we will describe the process to develop an IT architecture, and that will work whether it's a cloud architecture, enterprise architecture, or even a network architecture. The architecture process we will describe is very similar to the TOGRAPH framework, in that it's a systematic approach to architecture, and it's the key to developing a high performance, high availability, high security, and successful cloud architecture or enterprise architecture. Architecture is not just about technology. Sadly, we see many potential cloud architects who only think about the tech. Unfortunately, they have missed the point, as that's engineering, which is about the tech. Architecture is about driving business performance and digital transformation. The first step of the cloud architecture process is determining the vision for the company. And here, the key to remember is the business needs drive the architecture, not the technology itself. So the first part of the cloud architecture process is to find the business goals. What's the vision for the business? Where does the business want to be this quarter, next year, or even 5 years from now? And why is this so important? Well, the technology selected can either help the business get to their goals or keep the business from getting to their goals. Remember, technology has a major impact on the way business is conducted, as well as the way we live, work, and play. Now, in order to get to the business goals, we cloud architects and enterprise architects are going to have to speak to the organization's leadership, like the CEO, the COO, the CFO, the CIO, and the CTO. And once we know the future vision for the company, now we need to look at the actual business architecture. What is business architecture? Business architecture is actually how the business operates. For example, how does the sales process work? Or what do the people do in the finance department? What systems are in place? And by systems, we mean people, processes, and technology. What's working for the company today, and what's also not working that they'd like to change. Next thing we need to do is we need to work with a client to develop the future business architecture. And this is going to be typically called the target business architecture. And this is how the organization wants the business to operate in the future. And by future, we of course have to examine near-term, mid-term, and long-term, because we can't necessarily always do everything at once, and business is not a stagnant environment. When we know how the business wants to operate in the future, now we can map out or design the new business architecture. Now, next thing we need to do is perform a gap analysis between the current business architecture and the future business architecture, often called the target business architecture. And once we know the difference between the current state and the future state, now it's where we start building the plan. The plan to get to that end state, otherwise known as the target architecture. After the gap analysis, now we're in the ability to think about the transition and how we get there. Now, part of this is planning, where we have to consider the following. What steps need to occur to reach the end goal? Can we make a single change to get to the target architecture, or do we need to make multiple incremental changes, often called to architecture iterations? Once we have mapped out the business requirements and the business architecture, now the fun begins and we get to think about the technology. So So now the cloud architect or enterprise architect starts examining the organization's technology. Before we can develop a new architecture, we must baseline the current technology. For example, what systems are in place? What does the network look like? What does the computing platform look like? What does the data environment look like? What kinds of applications are deployed? How is the current technology performing? Is it working for the business? Is it not working for the business? Is it overloaded or does it have capacity? Next, we need to design the new technology architecture or the future architecture. This architecture is about supporting the new business architecture or how the business will operate in the future. This is about selecting the new technologies needing. In this phase, we must think of technology in generic terms. Servers, storage, security, artificial intelligence, etc. We must find the correct technology, not any vendor's particular technology. Remember, our concern is business optimization, not using any company-specific products like AWS, for example. Now, once we have designed the target technology architecture, we need to perform a gap analysis between the current architecture and the future architecture. We must consider the organization's readiness for change. Do they have the right people? Can they handle new business processes? Can they manage new technologies, etc.? And once that gap analysis is completed, we can plan what's needed to implement the future architecture. Can we make a single architectural change? Do we need several architecture iterations to get to the end goal? Now that we have developed the plan, we must get buy-in from key stakeholders to see if they agree with the end state of the business transformation and digital transformation. Once we get approval from all the key stakeholders, the architecture is finalized. Now we need to select the correct technology. This is where we determine which vendors have the best products for our particular solution. For example, do we get a firewall from Palo Alto Networks, Cisco, Fortinet, or Checkpoint, for example? For routers, do we get them from Cisco, Juniper Networks, or another vendors? Do we host our systems on a single cloud, hybrid cloud, multi-cloud, or hybrid multi-cloud? Once those decisions are made, we have to swap out the generic architecture for the vendor's gear. For example, if we're going to host our systems on AWS, we would swap out virtual machines or servers for EC2 instances. We would swap out virtual machine storage for block storage like EBS. Next, we document our solution and, of course, determine its cost. We also build a plan for the migration steps. We will also develop architectural work products like statements of work, diagrams, and documents explaining how the architecture works, and even a business case. Now we get to sell the architecture to the client. This means lots of meetings, client entertainment, and working with key stakeholders. Now we go close the deal. And if we did our job right, the client loves the design and they sign the contract. At this point, we hand over the architecture to an implementation team that will build and deploy the solution. Now, the implementation team may have project managers, cloud engineers, network engineers, security engineers, big data engineers, DevOps engineers, software engineers, and anybody else who will make the deployment successful. And now, as a cloud architect or an enterprise architect, we go move to the next client because our job is done. We designed the solution, presented it, got the customer's buy-in. Now you know the cloud architecture process, which is very similar to the enterprise architecture process, and you'll be well positioned to assist your clients with digital transformation. To learn how to get your first cloud architect job, please download the free ebook. The link is in the description below. And join us for the free webinar on how to become the ultimate cloud architect. Again, the link is in the description below. Please remember to like this video and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell to be notified of future videos to help you in your cloud architect or enterprise architect career. This is Mike Gibbs signing off, and I look forward to seeing you in another video. Take care.